you have this series. Let's take a break from the review problems and go to the book, okay? So Lewis has this question, the series from 2 to infinity, right? 1 over n, square root of n squared, minus 1. So supposing we didn't know it was from 11.3, what are the things you could do?
Compares.
We could try comparison, right? Compare with
what? What would you compare it to?
1/n. No, you can.
No. What's the leading term here?
N squared plus n squared.
You can compare it to this guy, right? Correct? Did you see what I did? Mm-hmm. All I did was I got rid of the minus.
N squared and n squared is n, isn't it?
And what is n times root n squared?
N squared.
Is n, right? So this will really just be what? 1/n squared.
Yeah.
And this is a P series, right? P is 2, bigger than 1. Therefore, what kind of series is this? This is a convergent P series, correct? Yeah. Okay. So what do you want
to do? You use the integral test in this problem.
I know. But I'm just saying, when you're out in the wild, nobody tells you what to do. Isn't it? You just have to like decide, okay, what can I do?
We're going to be out in the wild on our test.
On your test, you're out in the wild. I'm not going to tell you this is 11.3, correct? So this is what we're trying to do today as an exercise. We look at the problem and we have all our tests, right? And we see what can we do with this. Nth term test is automatically out, right? You see that? Mm-hmm. It goes to zero, so that doesn't help. So yeah, so maybe we can do a comparison test, right? What comparison can you do?
Didn't we just
If we want to use BCT, yeah, I just want us to think a little bit with just. If we want to use BCT, so this is your nth term that you want to test, right? And this is your other one that you already know, the associated series with this is convergent, right? Uh-huh. For basic comparison test to work, what should happen?
This one
should be bigger?
No, less than.
Should be smaller, right?
Smaller, yeah.
Is it smaller, though? No? So you put a big question mark here. Are you smaller? And you hope it is. But is it?
Yes, it is.
The denominator here is what? The denominator here is
smaller.
This denominator is smaller than that one, right? Yeah, so therefore, if this denominator is smaller than this one, then this guy really is
bigger.
So are we happy?
No.
Right? Do you understand? BCT doesn't work because it's the wrong direction. So therefore, who's your savior?
LCT.
Right? LCT is your savior, and what do you do with LCT? You put 1 over n, square root of n squared minus 1, that's your a sub n, right? Over b sub n, but over b sub n is the same as
multiplying
n squared over 1, so the n squared actually goes here, right?
Yeah.
Okay? So this will be n squared over n, root n squared minus 1, right?
Yeah.
And we can eyeball, right? The highest power in the numerator is n squared, right? Mm-hmm. And the coefficient is?
1.
So therefore, this goes to 1 on top. What about below?
1.
Also 1, because root of n squared is?
1.
N, right? N times n is? This is really n squared when you simplify, right?
Yeah.
Okay? The coefficient is 1. 1 over 1 is 1, which is a positive number. Conclusion?
Same.
They're both C. And was that the answer in the back? Although I know you're not happy because... No, but Sokowski didn't want us to use that, okay?
We have to find the sum.
Oh, and we have to find the sum. All right. But this, if you were just interested in the convergence, is this. So let us do the other possible test, which is what? The integral test, you said.
Actually, it says to use the integral test.
I know, but I'm just being stubborn. I want to play first, okay? But it's good to see the different options you have, right? Not just basically use integral tests. Did you have a question before we...
You guys see those three things, right?
Yeah. So let's define f of x. So f of x will be 1 over x times the root of x squared minus 1. So we have to check three things. First, is it positive?
Yes.
Yes, right? It's always positive over the interval 2 to infinity. So the interval in question is 2 to infinity, right? And will there be any discontinuities over that interval? No. So therefore it is continuous. Check. Okay. Then of course the pain is just in this, right? Getting the derivative.
You know, when we do the whole derivative thing, it seems like such tedious work. Because if the denominator of that function is clearly bigger, it has to be going down.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So do we even have to find the derivative?
I know, this is the second time Louis asked me this, right? And actually, I agree with him. It's like, gee, professor, do you have to be so mechanical? You agree with what he's saying?
Yeah.
Because actually, if you just use your head, professor, right? Okay. And I agree. You say, why do we have to? Well, you see that if x becomes bigger, right, that this thing gets smaller. And I see Mariana is saying, yeah, could you spare us, please, from this pain?
So spare.
Do you guys understand his point? Yeah. Okay. So this is decreasing. And so
you can write.
Oh, that's, we can skip
I
it,
think
right?
Sokowski does it blow by blow like this, right?
Mm-hmm.
He does, right?
You can write F-O-R for obvious reasons.
Like that? Okay. Did you understand his obvious reason? Right? Louis is very smart, I know. He thinks. He knows how to think, and but we are mechanical, right? We said, well, Sokowski said I have to show f prime of x, okay? But it's a good practice for our differentiation. Nothing is lost, right? Okay?
Except time.
So should I accept that?
Yeah.
Yes. But because I think, yeah, it's like, gee, it's a constant over something, right? That becomes bigger and bigger with time. Thank you, Louis. Okay, you finally won your case, okay? Did you record that? For obvious reasons, okay. All right, so then, yeah, because Louis is anxious to get to the exciting part of the game, right? What is the exciting part of the game? Yeah, he does that. Like, I want to do this now, right? Which is what? You integrate from?
To
infinity. And yeah, I agree with you. Those are the boring parts, right? Okay. Okay? So yeah, I guess then we can get the answer, right? Let's see, what was the graph of secant inverse or secant?
Let's pi just. Over two.
So then, pi over 2, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pi over 2, and arc secant of 2 is pi over
3,
right? Okay. So that's why you said there's an answer in the back, which is pi over 6. So therefore, the limit is pi over 6. And that's a very good point that Lewis raised. So pi over 6, we got an answer. What can we conclude from the fact that we got a finite number for an answer? The only conclusion we can draw is that the theories that we are interested in converges, right? And then the question was, is that the sum?
No.
Can somebody explain why that is not the sum?
Because it's continuous. It's continuous.
Yeah, remember for the integral, Josh said, the series really is just this, right? Correct? So the sum of the series will be that number plus this number plus this number plus this number plus this number. You understand? Correct? And you're wondering, is that a finite number? But when you do the integral test, you get the continuous case, right? So when you get the sum or the integral, it's really more stuff, correct? Okay? So the at most what you can conclude is the sum is what?
Less than pi over 6.
Oh, you guys are so smart. Okay, what would I do without you?